If you take a strip of paper, make a half twist, and tape the ends together, you get a Möbius strip. One of the weirdest things about Möbius strips happens when you cut them down the middle. Instead of coming apart like you might expect, they stay together. If instead you cut the Möbius strip a third of the way down, you get two loops that are interlinked. That's pretty neat, but why does it happen? Could we have predicted it before we made the cut? Let's start with the first phenomenon. Why does a Möbius strip stay together when we cut it down the middle? To see why, let's put a piece of string along the top and the bottom of the strip of paper before we twist it into a Möbius strip. When we make a half twist in the paper, the strings cross over each other, and when we tape it up, the two strings connect. What this shows is that a Möbius strip only has one connected edge, unlike a normal loop, which has a top edge and a bottom edge. When we cut down the middle of the Möbius strip, we never cut through the edge, so it has to stay connected. Now our loop has two edges, one edge, which was the original edge of the Möbius strip, and the other edge, which was the center of the Möbius strip. There's another way that we could have seen this fact. One way that mathematicians like to think about Möbius strips is with a diagram like this. We've drawn two arrows on either end of a strip of paper, but in opposite directions. This is to indicate that when we tape it together, we need to twist it so that the two arrows point in the same direction. A normal loop would have been drawn like this. These diagrams are convenient because they let us think about Möbius strips in a two-dimensional way, which is much easier to visualize. Another way to think about this diagram is that there are teleporters on either side of the strip, but oriented backwards. If a point passes through close to the top of one of the teleporters, it comes out on the other side, but close to the bottom. As an example, if we pass this smiley face through the teleporters, it comes out on the other side, but reflected upside down. If I cut through the middle, the entire strip is still connected, because you can get from the top half to the bottom half by passing through the teleporters. Now what about when I cut a third of the way down? This time, we need three strings, one for the top, the bottom, and the middle. We're going to do the same process of taping the Möbius strip together and connecting the strings along the way. If we make the twist but without the paper, it becomes pretty obvious what's going on. When we tape the strings together, we get two loops, but linked together. If I cut a third of the way down the Möbius strip, I never cut through the edge or the center, so these two loops have to stay linked together. Here's a bit of a bonus. If I take a strip of paper and make two half twists, I don't get a Möbius strip. However, if I cut through the middle, I'll still get two linked loops. Using what we've learned here today, can you explain why? Leave your answer in the comments. Today's video idea came from a comment, and if you have anything you'd like me to cover, please leave your suggestions in the comments below.